Hey Kong, I just closed my first wholesale deal. Now what do I do? Well, I'm gonna share with you what I did and what I didn't do. So hopefully this video will add some value to you. And if it does, please show me some love. Smash the thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the Wholesale to Million family. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure to turn on that bell notification because I pump out video almost every single day to help you take your business, your life to a whole nother level. You know, the whole goal is to add value to you, to hopefully that video will make an impact in your life and in your business so you can make more money and live your dream life. Intro. So basically, you know, I think after someone closed their first wholesale deal, you know, the hardest thing is that how do I continuously to get deal in every single month? Because a lot of times, you know, the first deal is always the hardest, right? We know that. But now how do we get from that one to like one every single month, and then two every single month, and then three every single month, you know? Like how can we be so consistent that we can kind of predict, right, our monthly income? Because I know a lot of you, you know, your goal is to be able to get to the point where, you know, your wholesaling business generates enough money where you can quit that stupid J-O-B. Dude, I was there, so I know how you feel, right? You're anxious, you wanna get there, and but you also afraid, like, hey, did I just get lucky closing on my first deal? Like, how do I know that I can actually repeat this process, but most importantly, go out, like, where I can actually do it every single month and not go out 3 to 4 months without a deal? So comment down below and let me know if that's something you're running into. Because I remember when I closed my first deal, man, I was happy and excited at the same time. But then I was like, well, can I do it again? Where, like, can I do it every month? Like, I know I can do it again, but how much longer is it going to take me to close another one and another one? So here's what I suggest you to do. So whether you're doing direct mail, whether you're doing cold call, whether you are doing RVM or text message, whatever it is, or Facebook ad, you need to continue keeping your pipeline going, right? Because, you know, it's like starting up the engine. You know, it's like if you shut the engine down and if you let it sit for a while, guess what? When you start it back up again, now you gotta wait for it to warm up. And that's the mistake that I made, is I cut off my marketing, right? Because I was so focused and locked in on getting that first deal done that it actually took me a while, right, to get the pace back going again, right? To get that engine going again so I can actually get another deal. And as far as in, well, how much money, Kong, do I need to put back into, right, my business after I close that first deal? Well, my take on that is don't put everything all back in. Always make sure that you stack some aside for saving, for reserve. So I wouldn't, like, it also depending on, obviously, like how much you made on the first deal. You know, if you're making between 5 to 10K, I would put 20 to 30% right back into the business, but back in to whatever that is working for you, getting you that first deal. Not trying out something new, because when you try it out something new, that's when it's going to cost you money, right? Because you're not familiar with it. So it takes time, and maybe you have to go through the trial and error, right, to actually get to where it's actually generating results. So I'll put back into whatever it's working for you. I highly recommend that you don't go fancy. Don't try to go fancy. Don't try to get systems and hiring team and hiring VA and go all at it. Because I'm telling you, like, the money can go very, very quickly if you don't know how to spend it wisely, right? And that's why people hire mentor and coaches and things like that, right? So they can actually coach you through things like this. Dude, I'm telling you, it's not from what I watch on YouTube or anything. I went through the experience myself. I got confident, I went this and that, and man, the money goes like that, and poof, I looked at my bank account, and 100K was gone, 200K was gone. Like, this is when I start, like, generating a lot of deals, and I was going into another market. I get all cocky, and I get all confident. I drop 30 to 40K in marketing, but I haven't learned that market yet. I should have slowed down and slowly creeped in and start knowing that market, building my teams and building the people in that market first and get familiarized with that market before I go kin kaboodle, right? Again, boom, and it was gone. So that's what I would do, right? Stack some saving aside for reserve. slowly increase your marketing. Focus on whatever it is that's working for you. Now, if you're cold calling, I would suggest that you maybe now invest into the cold calling system because it's going to get you much more productive, but it doesn't cost that much per month. So the company that we use for cold call is Call Tools. So calltools.com/WTM. If you use my affiliate link, like, they will hook you up with a monthly discount. I don't know how much it is, like 30, 40 bucks discount per month. Or I think the promo code is WTM. But don't get all fancy and start getting all the systems and everything like that, you know, things that you watch on YouTube and people are trying to sell you. Like, to me, like, you're not ready yet. You're ready when you get to the point where you can consistently pumping out one deal a month, another deal, like one deal at least every single month, right? And then now you know that, hey, you know what? It start for now. I got some cash. Now I'm going to start investing. Obviously, if you're closing, you know, a 30K deal, a 40K deal, a 50K deal, I wouldn't take 50%, right, and dump it back into your business. You know, maybe 15%, maybe 10%. Like I said, slowly but surely, right, you will get there. But don't go crazy, okay? But I also know that there's some of you that close on a good, you know, on a deal and afraid to spend the money. And listen to me, man. Scare money. And this is what I learned from you. This is what I heard on YouTube or Instagram from somebody. I don't know who it is. Scare money, don't make money, all right? If you're afraid to spend the money, man, you're not going to make the money. And your end up costing is that a lot of time wasted. You know, you got, dude, you, when you start making some money, it's time to reinvest, right? Reinvest it back in. And listen, man, you got to have that confidence knowing that, you know, you did it once. You already know the process. Be confident in yourself, all right? And just repeat the same process, man. You see, you cold call and got a deal. There's no way that pulling a list, right? Okay, now let's talk about lists. I would dump some money pulling a bigger list. Now, don't try to go into another county, another city so quickly. Still focus on your farming area. Focus on your farming area, right? But pull a bigger list. Maybe before you were only pulling, you know, pre-foreclosure vacant. Now you need to pull like high equity. Anybody that's owned 50% or more in equity to free and clear, that's gonna give you a bigger list. You know, tax delinquents, probates, right? Start investing in bigger lists. Now your skip trace is gonna increase, right? Because now you have a bigger list to skip trace. And I will slowly, right, dump money in whatever's working for you. But you gotta understand, you need to spend the money, man. Don't be afraid, because I think I remember back like, I don't know, a year or two ago, someone closed on a wholesale deal, one of my subscribers, 28K, and he DM'd me or something or messaged me on Facebook and said, Kong, I'm afraid to spend the money because I don't know if I can actually do it again, right? So you got to be confident in yourself. Understand that the money you spent is going to come back in. Like you can't get deals without spending the money on marketing or continue to do whatever you're doing. So that is my take and that's my advice. I hope this video will add some value to you guys. And I want you to understand that, you know, to start closing one deal every single month, you got to make sure you keep your marketing consistent, all right? And to the point when you know that you're ready to hire a VA or an employee is when you get into the point where you're cranking out, you know, 8 to 10 hours a day just sitting there filtering, qualifying the lead. You know that is too much work, right? And I think, you know, when you have, you know, 6 months to a year reserved to pay for VAs or pay for employee, I think that's when you know that you can afford to hire one, right? Start leveraging other people, right? When you know that you can continue closing one deal every single month, right? And then you've closed, you know, for the next 5 months, I think it's about time, right? For you to now amp up your game, get a team in place, right, start having them, right, seeking for system and putting system into place so now you can crank out 2 to 3 deals a month, all right? But the key really comes down to is marketing. How much money can you put back into marketing to keep your pipeline going, all right? But also, too, is make sure that you don't go crazy, all right, where to the point where you are a solo, right? You're so solopreneur and all these leads coming in, but you can't handle the volume. So slowly increase, right? Close another one, and then invest into a VA's employee and to more systems to make sure that you are not working in, but instead of working on your business. Anyways, you guys, thank you so much. Hope this video, it's not too long, not too boring. If you're new to the channel, once again, boom, smash that thumbs up, show me some love, hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell notification so when I upload a new video or when I go live, which I do every single Friday, 9 a.m. Pacific Standard, I do a live cold call role play to help you take your communication skill, your negotiating skills with the seller to a whole nother level. Because I believe the number one skill set that you need to learn and master in this business, the number one, not marketing, not anything, is knowing how to talk and negotiate with the seller. If you're having trouble with that and if you need help, check out my King Kong script. Link is down below. Use my promo code. I think there's a promo code right now on the website. Get a 25% off. And anyways, I wish you massive success. Good luck with everything. Keep pushing. Keep going. This journey ain't easy, but we both know that it's going to be worth it. And I'll see you at the top. Take care and ciao.